welcome once again to Salvation Army Community Church here in Meadowlands, Ancaster. A call to worship. Let's pray together. Creator and Father in heaven, as we gather for worship today, we acknowledge you as our light to lead us through dark places. Dark places in our world, the dark places our loved ones find themselves in, the dark places of our neighbors, and we acknowledge that you are the light for our lives and the light for living in these dark places. Lord, none of us can escape hardship in life, but we can change the way we think about hardship. Hardships can be opportunities to draw alongside someone, offer comfort and care and understanding. Hardships in life are markers that focus us on the main things in life. As early followers of Jesus endured hardships, we pray that the hardships we encounter will strengthen our faith and our determination to be followers of you. Open our ears, open our eyes, open our hearts to identify hardship in others. Help us be obedient to your voice as to how we can share hope in the midst of their hardships. The Apostle Paul writes in 2 Thessalonians 1-4, "Therefore, among God's churches, we boast about your perseverance and faith in all the persecutions and trials you are enduring." Lord, we pray, grow us and grow our faith. In and through the name of Jesus, amen. Trust and pray you will enjoy the service today.
Give us a day of wonders, Jehovah, bear thine arm. Pour out thy Holy Spirit, make known thy healing balm. Give blessings without number, supply us from thy store. Dear Savior, richly bless us, baptize us more and more. Lord, hear us while we pray. Lord, hear us while we pray. Thy Spirit give, let the dying live, and bless us here today. Lord, hear us while we pray. We offer thee this temple, with power, Lord, enter in. And teach us when we worship, or wage the war with sin. Oh, may the sinner find thee within these hallowed walls. Here may young eager spirits obey when Jesus calls. Lord, hear us while we pray. Lord, hear us while we pray. Thy Spirit give, let the dying live, and bless us here today. Lord, hear us while we pray. For the battle, give strength our foes to slay. Give light to cheer the darkness, give grace from day to day. Give rest amidst life's conflict, give peace when lions roar. Give faith to fight with patience, till fighting days are o'er. Lord, hear us while we pray. Lord, hear us while we pray. Thy Spirit give, let the dying live, and bless us here today. Oh, oh. And give us a day of wonders. Give us a day of wonders. Give us a day of wonders. And give us a day of wonders. give us a day of wonders, and give us a day of wonders. Oh, 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 oh. Give us grace, give us faith, give us blessings without number, Lord. Give us grace, give us faith, give us blessings without number, Lord. Yeah, give us grace, give us faith, give us blessings without number, Lord. Lord, hear us while we pray. Lord, hear us while we pray. Thy Spirit give, let the dying live, and bless us here today. Lord, hear us while we pray. Lord, hear us while we pray. Thy Spirit give, let the dying live, and bless us here today. Lord, hear us while we pray. Give us grace, give us faith, give us blessings without number, Lord.
Good morning, boys and girls, moms and dads, and Meadowlands Church family. Today I want to talk to you about building our church. So I thought, I'm going to drive over to our church. So I had Dan drive me over to the church, and I thought, I'm going to go into the nursery and see if I can find something in here that I could use to build a church. So it took me a few minutes, but I built this church. I really miss my friends in the nursery and my little lamb, so I didn't have anybody to help me, so I did my best. I don't know, what do you think of my church? It's got a fancy little arch on the top. It's got a roof, so it's not going to get wet. There's a couple little windows, a big door. So I think it's a pretty nice church. I think we could go to church in something like this. You could go in there to worship and to be with each other and to listen to the Bible and to pray and to do all those wonderful things when we go to church. We all miss coming to our church here in Ancaster. It's a lot more fun to worship Jesus and to learn about Jesus when we can all be together. Now, is the church just a building? What do you think? It's important as Christians who love and follow Jesus to come to church, be together, and hopefully someday we can come back to our church. But did you know that the church is actually not just a building? A church is a group of people, both young and old, who love Jesus and want to follow Jesus and want to tell others about Jesus. So I'm going to show you what the real church is. So here's our real church. Here's Luna and Kaya and Drake and Bishop, and Everly, and Emma, and Jenna, but I don't have any sparkles on Jenna, Mackenzie, and Quinton, and Logan, and Quinn, and the other Emma, and Allie, and Colton, and Lorelai, and Alyssa, and Iggy, and Jack, and the list goes on and on. So we do want to build our church, but what I mean by building our church is supporting each other, telling other people about Jesus if they don't know him, so they can learn to follow Jesus just like us. So the next time you look in the mirror, I want you to remember that when you look at yourself, you're actually looking at the church. So have a great day, everyone, and God bless. Bye for now.
Thank you. We are continuing with our sermon series of New Directions as we unpack the vision statement of the Salvation Army in the Canada and Bermuda Territory, and as we continue to look at the book Christ at the Door by Commissioner Phil Needham. And just a reminder of that vision statement of the Salvation Army in Canada and Bermuda, we are an innovative partner, mobilized to share hope wherever there is hardship, building communities that are just and know the love of Jesus. Well, I firmly believe that we in the Salvation Army desire to be a movement that is mobilized to continue to share hope wherever there is hardship in others. Last week, I was challenged by Lieutenant Colonel Susan's message about the mission and identity of the local church. We are commissioned to take up the message of the gospel and the mission of God into our world, into our communities, on our street, with our families. This mission is lived out in many places outside the church walls. And haven't we experienced that this past 15 to 16 months, my friends? We have learned to live the mission of God outside the walls of a church building. We've not been able to meet together in person, but we've continued to meet together on screens, over phones, and at times in person with one or two people in our backyards or on our front steps. We have been sharing hope with each other. Some of us have been able to do that with our neighbors and others around the world through our Partners in Mission campaign, when we have given of our financial resources so that we could share hope with those who are experiencing hardship in other parts of the world. We have had to learn to be creative in how we meet the needs of others and how we bring hope to those who are suffering many forms of hardship. We have been witnesses to how others have brought hope to those experiencing challenging circumstances. And some of you have been recipients of the help of others. We've reached out to others by providing meals. We've reached out to others by calling them because we know that they are going through a difficult experience. We've sent cards, and you've sent emails and text messages to one another so you can share hope in the midst of this global pandemic. I want to remind you this morning of a few words I shared with you in my message 3 weeks ago, because those words continue to resonate in my heart and my mind as I was preparing my thoughts to share today. See, we are a movement, the Salvation Army, a movement that is mobilized to partner with others in our community so that we can share hope with those who are experiencing hardship. Let me read to you a passage of scripture that I referred to 3 weeks ago, Matthew chapter 25, but I'm going to read the entire text to you today, verses 31 to 46. Matthew 25, verse 31. When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate the people from one another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison, or go to visit you?" The king will reply, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me." Then he will say to those on his left, Depart from me, you who are cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me nothing to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not invite me in. I needed clothes, and you did not clothe me. I was sick and in prison, and you did not look after me. They also will answer, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or needing clothes or sick or in prison and did not help you? He will reply, truly I tell you, whatever you did not do for one of the least of these, you did not do for me. Then they will go away to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. Many people make reference to the Salvation Army when they talk about these verses of Scripture, particularly verses 34 to 40. Because many people, the Salvation Army, many people believe that the Salvation Army has embodied this passage of Scripture of feeding the hungry, caring for those who have no clothes, visiting the sick, visiting those who are in prison, giving a drink of water when somebody is thirsty. The Salvation Army has been a church that has taken seriously the invitation of God to partner with Him in caring for the most vulnerable in our world. And we have a wide variety of community and social services ministries around the world. I shared that with you 3 weeks ago. We have them here in Canada. We have them in Ontario Division. And we have them here in Hamilton. This is how the Salvation Army has learned to share hope with those or experiencing hardship. And we here at the Meadowlands Community Church provide the ministry of music and the ministry of presence in many of these locations here in the city of Hamilton. We have the opportunity to share hope through the ministry of music and also the conversations that we engage in with the people at the Booth Center, with the people that we encounter at the many nursing and retirement homes that we visit, we are provided with the unique opportunity to share with others the reason for our hope. And the reason for our hope is Jesus. We also read in Scripture how Jesus brought hope to many. When He released Mary Magdalene from the 7 demons that plagued her, He brought her hope for a better life. When He restored sight to blind Bartimaeus, He brought hope. When He healed the lame man by the pool, He gave that man hope for a better future. When He spent time with the children, He gave them hope. When He stopped the bleeding of the woman who had been bleeding for many years, and when He raised the young girl from the dead, He brought hope to her family. In Mark chapter 2, we read how some friends shared hope with a paralyzed man by bringing him to Jesus. In Acts chapter 3, verses 1 to 10, we read the account of Peter, who healed the lame beggar at the temple gate. But this is what Peter said to him. He said, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I do have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk." Acts chapter 3, verse 6. You see, what Peter gave to this lame beggar, was he gave him hope. He gave him hope by sharing with him Jesus. In our Connections conversations on Tuesday night, this past Tuesday night, we heard from 3 panelists of how they are sharing hope with those in their neighborhood, sharing hope with those where their church is located, sharing hope in their city. They have learned to be creative and innovative in how they are meeting the needs of others. And that's what we all need to do, my friends. We need to be creative and innovative, maybe even radical, in how we serve suffering humanity, those who are experiencing hardship, how we share hope with them, and how we help them grow into a deeper relationship with Jesus Christ. Maybe we are called to step outside our comfort zones, doing something that we're not comfortable doing, if that's what we feel Jesus is calling us to do in order to meet the needs of others, in order to share hope wherever there is hardship. Maybe we are hearing or sensing in our spirit that God is calling us to do something radically different, or God is calling you and I to do something that's outside our comfort zone, but we feel it burning within us. The Holy Spirit leading us and directing us to do something, to share hope, the hope that we have in Jesus as we share our stories with other people, because Jesus has brought us hope. Commissioner Needham, in his book, Christ at the Door, in chapter 7, he challenges us to think about who we are and who we have become. Have we become institutionalized and insulated in our local church? Have we become a perfectionist sect that invites only those who are willing to become like us? You can ask yourself the question, who is the us? Do we want them to look like us? To act like us? Do we want them to sing like us? Or worship like us? Are we concerned about keeping the programs going and the machinery running? Have we allowed ourselves to become so focused on tradition that we have forgotten our mission to share hope wherever there is hardship? If so, Commissioner Needham says, we have become like an institution and not a church that's mobilized to live out its mission in our community. Commissioner Needham further goes on to say, maintenance without a mission focus leads ultimately to death spiritually and numerically. That's sad. That's very sad. If we lose sight of our mission, if we lose sight of the vision to share hope wherever there is hardship, then it can lead not only to our church declining in numbers, but it can lead to us declining in our spiritual growth and development, because we are called to be disciples of Jesus Christ, to be transformed every day along this journey of our faith. Commissioner Needham goes on to say in his book that every salvationist, I would say every follower of Jesus, is called to be a disciple all the time, no exceptions. Every morning, Christ stands at the door of our lives and he invites us to enter into the world as his countercultural, authentic disciples. It's a full-time calling, not a part-time job. You see, one of the priorities of the church, the local church, one of the priorities of Meadowlands Community Church here in Hamilton, is to prepare its members for mission through discipleship. Not just in the church, where we spend 10% of our time, but to be involved in discipleship and to grow in discipleship for the mission in our community, where we spend 90% of our time. What a solid church is capable of doing in mission is considerable. What its members are capable of doing in mission outside the church walls is extraordinary. Extraordinary, my friends, what you and I are capable of doing with the Spirit of the living God at work in our lives, in our communities, it's extraordinary. As God's ever-growing, ever-changing disciples, God expects us to share hope wherever there is hardship. God so loved the world. So we are called to partner with God in sharing and showing his love in the world and sharing hope wherever there is hardship. That's God's mission. And he invites us to partner with him in this mission in our community and around the world. This week, we received an email from the Salvation Army here in Ontario. We have been invited to donate to COVID relief in India. Please consider how much you are willing to give financially in order to share hope wherever there is hardship in India right now. And we can all agree, my friends, that right now India is experiencing hardship and they need our help. They need our help to share hope because the people of India need hope today. The Salvation Army is accepting donations to provide life-saving emergency support, including PPE, hygiene and sanitation kits, food assistance and medical supplies. And if you wish to donate to this cause, if you wish to donate to the Salvation Army in Canada and Bermuda, specifically saying that your donation is for COVID relief in India, or if you want to donate to the Salvation Army Meadowlands Community Church, but specify that your donation is for COVID relief in India, we invite you to do that. And a bit later on in our service, you will see a donate button, or it'll be in the chat box, or it will be on the video description, how you can make this donation. We invite you to do so, because this is an opportunity. We have been invited to share hope wherever there is hardship. Let me encourage you today as well, my friends, to think of ways that you can share hope with those who are experiencing hardship on your street, in your community, in our church. What are some practical ways you can do that? Well, one of the practical ways I believe we can share hope is just by our very presence. Now, I know that you can't be physically present with somebody right now because of this lockdown and stay-at-home orders, but you can be present with people on a phone call. You can be present with people through a text message. You can FaceTime people. You can set up a Zoom call. You can email them. You can send cards to them, letting them know that you are with them in whatever hardship they are experiencing. You can provide meals to people who are not well at this time, who find it hard to prepare a meal for themselves. You can give financial support to the many ministries of the Salvation Army here in Hamilton, in the country of Canada, and around the world. You can give financial assistance to those places who are providing hope with people who are experiencing hardship at this time. We are called to be an army, a church on the move, a church, a movement that is mobilized to carry out God's mission in the world, to share hope wherever there is hardship. We are called to mobilize, to live out our holiness in our church, at work, at school, on our street, in our community. And Jesus invites us to partner with him on this mission of sharing hope wherever there is hardship. And I share with you, as I shared with you 3 weeks ago, because I believe it really comes down to this, what we call the Christian Shema, that we are to love the Lord our God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our strength, with all of our mind, and we are to love our neighbor as ourselves. And when we love others, we share hope with them when we know that they're experiencing hardship. It sounds simple, doesn't it? But I know, my friends, that it is sometimes hard. I want to conclude this morning these thoughts I've shared with you by reading the words of a song, 695. You can find it in the Salvation Army Psalmbook. You can Google it and find it online. And perhaps you could do that and listen later on today to this song. Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name. Will you care for cruel and kind and never be the same? Will you risk the hostile stare should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me? Will you let the blinded see if I but call your name? Will you set the prisoners free and never be the same? Will you kiss the leper clean and do as such as this unseen and admit to what I mean in you and you in me? Will you love the you hide if I but call your name? Will you quell the fear inside and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around through my sight and touch and sound in you and you in me? Lord, your summons echoes true when you but call my name. Let me turn and follow you and never be the same. In your company I'll go, where your love and footsteps show, thus I'll move and live and grow in you and you in me. Challenging words, my friends. Let them sink in. Will you step outside your comfort zone? Will I step outside my comfort zone to answer the call of God to share hope wherever there is hardship? And God bless you this week as you allow those words to sink into your heart, speak to you, and listen to what Jesus is saying to you in these days. Let us pray. Father, I thank you for your word once again today that challenges us to go and be your disciples in our world. To go and share hope wherever there is hardship. To go and share the hope that we ourselves have found in Jesus in our own lives. To be willing to share our story with others. And that when we share our story, we might bring hope to someone else. Open our ears, Lord, this week to hear your voice, to whatever you might be calling us to do. And then you'll give us the courage to step out and do whatever it is you have called us to do. We thank you, Lord, because you are always with us. We thank you because you will give us the courage and the wisdom and the strength we need to love you and to love others. We praise you, we honor you. And Lord, we think just now of India, a place that is experiencing hardship in so many ways. May you convict us and challenge us as to how we might give to support the efforts in India so we can bring hope where there is such hardship right now. Thank you for loving us. Help us to love others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Consoled as to console, to be honest. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come in your presence today. We come not as strangers, but as your children. And you are Heavenly Father. It's good to be able to come into your presence and have this time to set aside the cares of life and the busyness of living. Help us to lay aside thoughts that will distract us, but help us to concentrate on the blessings that you have available to us through worship. We thank you for your faithfulness, mercy, and grace. You are always there when we need you. You never turn us away. You never fail us. God, for those listening to this service, help us to drown out thoughts that will hinder your Holy Spirit from moving, from speaking to and challenging our hearts. Help us to be attentive to what the Holy Spirit is saying to us. Father, we live in a world today with so many concerns, so many uncertainties. Our hearts ache for the many who are dealing with COVID-19, the families who have lost loved ones because of the virus. We think about those working tirelessly on the front lines. We pray for the families that they will receive your comfort and strength. For those on the front lines, you will continue to be with them. giving them courage to face each day and all its challenges. O God, we come to you this morning and we pray for the needs of our people. For some, the days are filled with loneliness, disappointment, and heartaches. Some dealing with sickness. They have reasons to be sad. They need you. They need the comfort of your Holy Spirit. Help them to know that they are loved and being prayed for. Let them know that they are going to be okay because you hold them in your hands. Oh God, we pray that you will help us to be all that we can be for you. Help us to be your hands and your feet in this church and in our community. God, I pray that people will see you in the way we live our lives. Continue to bless us today and in the days to come. For we ask it in your name. Amen.
Let us continue our time of worship this morning with an opportunity to say thanks to God for his many blessings as we return his portion in our offering. If you're watching this by YouTube, click the link in the video below. And if you're joining us by Zoom, the link will be shared in the chat room now. We are glad that you have joined with us this morning at Meadowlands, and we invite you to attend again next week when we continue to explore biblical keys to our salvation's future by being made aware of needs in self. May we continue to cultivate a deep love for Jesus and spread that love like seeds in our neighborhoods, communities, and cities. Let us be dispensers of hope in our world by the way we live our lives. Lives that are motivated by compassion, demonstrating the love of God in the power of his Holy Spirit. And now our benediction, as found in Ephesians chapter 3. I pray that from his glorious and limited resources, he will empower you with inner strength through his Spirit. Then Christ will make his home in your hearts. As you trust in him, your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. And may you have the power to understand, as all God's people should, how wide, how long, how high, and how deep his love is. May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to understand fully. Then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. Now, all glory to God, who is able, through his mighty power at work within us, to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Glory to him in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. Amen.